Hi everyone, this is Bibi Cameron here. Welcome to a new video. I hope you are doing well and stay safe. Today, I'm going to be sharing about the ultimate craft room storage solution, the Dream Box. I'm also going to be sharing my experience in building this craft room or building this crafting space. I was due to do this, but finally, I got the opportunity to do it. Having or building a creative space has been an adventure. As we bought a small house about 3 years ago, I didn't have any room to store my supplies in there. We decided to use the garden to build a log cabin. We explored our options, and buildings under 2.5 meters doesn't require planning permission here in Scotland. So we save money in additional fees for building, and we also save a lot of time. Now you will find different quality buildings with different kind of windows, different kind of roof, and many different designs. So the prices might vary depending the size of the building, the features, and also the quality of the materials. There are many companies that offer buildings like this online, and you might have something local. We choose local and we pay about £4,900 for the building. You will also need to build a base for the building. We decided to build a concrete base, and the company that sold us the log cabin recommend a couple of gardeners that have many years building these kind of bases on gardens. And in a couple of days, we had the base done. We were advised to allow the base to dry for at least 2 weeks. And we also read that having a gravel edge around the log cabin will help to keep the building healthy, acting as drainage, and also avoiding plants from growing into the building. The price, £1,350, and that was done. And my log cabin arrived from Germany in about 6 weeks. And I also have to make a queue to get a team to assemble the cabin for me. And building the cabin took about 8 hours. This was extremely quick. And the people who put it together, they were very organized. They placed all the pieces that were in that parcel on the garden, like you can see them, the parts of a puzzle, and then they start building this with easy. I believe that even to do this, that seems to be a very simple task, could be very time consuming for a person who doesn't know what is what, like me. So we read about putting this together ourselves, and we say, no way, we can't do this. And we believe that it's better to leave this kind of work to the professionals and the people who really know what they are doing. And I love watching people building things. I learned little things from this. And they were working in such coordination that allowed them to speed up the process. And while one of them was doing one side of the room, the other one was doing the other side. And they help each other. It was so super cool to see them working so coordinated to build this cabin in record time. So the last bit here was building the roof. And once this was done, they fitted the door. And just for the record, I was told that the logs expand or contract depending the temperature. So you might need to adjust the door several times. In 3 years, I have to adjust the door 4 times because it was hard to open it or hard to close it, depending the weather, depending the season. The next thing they did was fitting the floor that is also made out of these logs. And after that, they just installed the roof covering. And this is a kind of protected chimney that will avoid water from coming inside the log cabin. I don't have idea what is the material, and I believe this is additional to the price of the log cabin. And for this log cabin that measures 6 meters by 3 meters 30 centimeters, this might cost up to £500 with installation. Once the roof covering was in place, they also added a wooden frame all around the edges of the roof, and the log cabin was finished. The next step is thinking about painting. After doing some research, I decided to buy Sadoline because this paint offers high quality and effective wood protection for up to 8 years. So there was nothing fancy about painting the cabin. It took me a week or so, and as you see there, I use a brush and a roller. Once I was done, I was fitting for very first time flooring, and that was the floor of my craft room. I also added a layer of insulation, and that's the blue thing that you see underneath the floor. You can see the bare walls and roof. This is the only truth I have about this before painting. And to add a nice rich color to that roof, I also apply it with a sponge decking oil. So little by little, you will see how this room changed. And this is how the room looks when it's painted inside in white and the floor is in place. This is one side of the room and this is the other. Next, you need to hire a qualified electrician to install a cable from your house to your log cabin and to fit all the electric parts that you might require. I went ahead and I bought some lamps that were totally useless, and this was 3 years ago. Now, today, I have completely different lighting in my craft room, and you will see those ahead in this video. Emma was supervising the work and she was very curious about mommy's new house in the garden. Well, the only thing that I really was assertive in getting regarding lighting or the lamps for my craft room was this little lamp here that David is going to install in the front of the craft room. They are very useful. They lighten up the garden in the evening. So this was a really clever solution. Highly recommended if you are planning to get a log cabin. You also might need some flowers and decorative elements. And from here, the sky is the limit. You can adequate your log cabin for a craft room in endless ways. When I start crafting here in the UK, I had that small folding table in a bedroom, and that was all I had to create. And then I start gathering pieces of furniture, but I would say more junk that I could get for free or from IKEA. And I did loads of DIY. I changed the fabric of this chair, for example, to completely transform that old piece of furniture. I covered my work surfaces using adhesive paper. And I also saw in Pinterest an idea to make my own paper rack or paper organizer. And it seems to be a good idea. I went for it, but with the time, the dividers to hold the paper that were made out of wood, they bended and the piece of furniture start looking tired. It has many other pieces of DIY furniture I made during all these years. It also ended up in the recycling center. And even though I tried to make the best with what I got from IKEA, and of course this is when I just moved in, I don't have a proper video about the first craft room setup, but I found this clip here that you can see and you can have an idea. After this, I made 2 trips to IKEA, and these are 16 hours driving, 1,200 pounds spent there in extra furniture and decorations and little containers and things to try to get organized. After 1 year of crafting in this space, I decided that I needed a change, and I bought kitchen cabinets. I bought a white Dakota kitchen for reference. You can just Google search this. It's the most affordable kitchen cabinet that you can find in the market with delivery for a price under £500. And I also got a new table from IKEA again. I cannot resist it. And it cost me £130. And for 2 years, this was pretty much my craft room setup. In this area here, I used to have IKEA units, but when I filmed this clip here, I took them out because I was getting ready for a change. And I'm going to show you first why I decided to have another change in my craft room. So when you have this kind of furniture, I don't know if you think the same, you tend to put things there and you might forget you have them. Sometimes I throw things without thinking how I throw them. And when you are crafting, you don't want to stop and have to clean anything. You just want to keep creating. So the IKEA cabinets or the all Kallax units that I have here with fabric and other supplies, they were like in this condition. Pretty bad, right? I have all kind of supplies piling up there. I might never see them. I might never use them. And this is not more than getting real. I have my foil like that, my express like that, and I struggle. I try to get as organized as possible, trying to get different display units for my inks, but I run out of space. And if you are a crafter, you know that we always run out of space. So I try many different things. And the reality of these kitchen cabinets is that they are wide and deep, and it's easy to just throw things inside and forget about it. Close the doors and you are all organized. Look at that. But now we all know my ugly truth. Many years ago, I saw this beauty and I just thought that she was too expensive. And instead, I decided to take the long road that you already saw, that it was a lot more expensive and you already know the outcome as well. But God is good, and last December, she landed to my door after 6 weeks waiting for her, and she came right from the USA in this box. So I emptied partially my craft room to be able to place her there, and I want to show you the contents of this box and everything about this amazing storage solution for our craft rooms. I have to admit that after doing such amount of DIY, I was facing here a large piece of furniture to put together again. So you can see there the unboxing of the dream box. It took about 10 minutes to get everything in my craft room. And as you could see there, there was a big portion of this box filled with the plastic containers and different shelves that are going to fit the box. There is a pre-assembled option. Sadly, when I got the box, this option wasn't available. And in that case, you will get the double size of this box and your dream box is going to be pre-assembled. So everything is going to be easier than what I'm going to show you here. So I first read the instructions and I try to spend as much time as possible doing it to avoid making mistakes. The first thing you need to install is the wheels to the different bottom panels of the box. And then from there, I found everything very easy. I have the experience with the IKEA cabinets, and I have the experience also building the kitchen cabinets. So doing this wasn't particularly difficult. I have to say that I didn't even have a scratch in my hands or breaking my nails doing this. I usually do that when I'm making cards or things like that. But when I was putting this together, I didn't. And I'm not 100% healthy neither. I believe I have something that is called BII, that is the breast implant illness, and that's something I might share with you later on. So even though that I wasn't feeling 100%, and this is something not new, this is for the four past years, I found this easy to do. The only really hard part was lifting the heavy pieces of the dream box. Is heavy. I have to call my husband in a couple of occasions to help me to lift the pieces. But if you see there, this just involves a lot of screwing and understanding how to put the things together in a strategic way to avoid extra work, extra effort, and damaging your back. You will also find that all the different parts of the dream box comes with a label, so it's easy to identify all the different parts and fittings of your dream box. I I made a little mistake because I fit the drawers first and I should fit the shelving that goes over those drawers first and then fit the drawers. So I just removed them, placed the shelving and put the drawers again. That was super easy to fix. Anything else that you see there is pretty much to find the right pieces to put together and screw them in place. I also tried to find the most comfortable positions to be able to finish different tasks. Fitting the shelf in different compartments of the drink box was very easy, but very time consuming. You need to plan out the height of the items you are going to place on different areas. And in the instructions of the drink box, you will find the ideal setups for your drink box. But remember that it's yours and you can do anything with hair once you get it. You can just personalize it, decorate this by colors, doing whatever you want. I just use this as an instrument of work. So what it matters to me is that she will be the home of my paper craft supplies. And now I'm going to be able to see them all just in one place. And when I open this box, I will access to all these things that were spread all over my craft room before. I also want to add that the things you see there in the floor are just some of the things I fit in the dream box, because I fit many more that were in my kitchen cabinets. And now in my kitchen cabinets, I have all the sewing supplies I have and machines and things that were lying on the floor. So the dream box gives me the space or the room to do that as well. At the moment, I fit the 90% of my paper craft supplies there. I can't say how many supplies I fit there, but at least those are the ones I need the most and I use the most. I also have a trolley that contains all my mediums, and I have some supplies still in my kitchen cabinets. My dream box is looking like that. I didn't add anything to cover the front of the clear containers because I really need to see what is inside. I select the paper I'm going to use. I also have scraps of paper in one container, and as you see there, I have my dies and my stamps in these containers. They fit loads and loads of stamps. I try to keep the stamps and dies in the original packaging when possible, and if not, I just store them without packaging at all. I use those poly pockets with labels before, but I found that they take more room within the container, and because I use my supplies very often, those pockets were showing signs of wear and tear, and that wasn't looking nice. So I decided to keep only some dies on those pockets. And well, that's it. There is nothing fancy about the way I store items, and I store them according to the brand, so that makes it easy to identify different supplies. Last but not least, I would like to invite you to visit my blog post with pictures, more information, and discount codes for the Dream Box. I have established a collaboration with Create Room that enabled me to have early access to sales as well, and the sales are crazy. Last Black Friday, they offer $1,000 off your dream box, and I have codes 24 hours before the sale started, so that people secure the dream box with that crazy big discount. Please check the links in the video description to see which is the last discount code available. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel or visit my blog for more ideas and inspiration. Thank you very much for watching, and happy crafting. Bye.